This is our third Sunday of Advent, and we are going to prepare ourselves for Advent. Amen? If we can call Sister and Brother Love up.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
Giving honor to God. I tell you, this is a very, very special recognition of Advent for me. Because when you talk about joy, that's something powerful. A lot of times we think about joy of home ownership, the joy of birth. But there's a lot more to joy than just material things.
Amen.
And forgive me if I get a little emotional, but I'm full of joy this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Like Pastor said, we have a lot to be thankful for. And that's a reason to have joy. I think about a song for Sean Mitchell, Joy. He gives me joy. And I use the word ownership. And I want you to hold on to that word, own, because it's going to be a part of my acronym this morning for joy. And forgive me, Pastor, for just taking a little time here this morning, but I want everybody to just feel the spirit of joy. You know, this morning, as I read, it says, the wilderness will dance and the dry places will sing praises to God. When we see the glory of the Lord revealed, we will be strengthened and saved. God's peace opens our eyes. God's gifts of hope opens our heart. With joy, we will praise the promised Savior of the world. Think about this prayer. Holy God, create in us a fountain of joy. Stir in us a spirit of dance. Kindle in us the fire of gladness. Set loose in us songs of praise. For you are the one who comes with healing and blessings. Amen. Now I want to tell you this, and then we will light the candles. I did a little research, and in the Bible, the word joy is used 165 times. And when you look at the fruits of the Spirit, let's think about that. The fruits of the Spirit. In the King James Version, the first word is love, because God is love. Then the second word is joy. So God is doing some powerful things, just like Pastor said, in 2017, and he's going to do some even greater things in 2018.
Amen. Amen.
So I want you to think about this acronym of JOY, J-O-Y, and I talked about ownership. The J stands for Jesus. The O stands for own. The Y stands for you. Because he owns you. And you should be joyous of the fact that he owns you. There's no greater person, or there's nothing that's greater than knowing that, hey, I have somebody that gives me joy and owns me. I'm thankful for that. Thankful to be here this morning, to let God use me, my wife, everyone in this sanctuary, because he didn't have to do it.
Thank you.
Didn't have to do it.
Thank you.
So I leave that with you, and I just pray that you would just take the word joy with you throughout. throughout this week and pass it on to somebody and let them know that Jesus owns you and he will provide and protect and care for us. Amen. We're going to light the candles. Powerful word.
Amen.
Powerful word.
Thank you.
We have a lot, a whole lot. And if we let him use us,
thank you.
That's what it's all about, letting him use you because he owns you.
Thank you.